Welcome to Understanding Cancer. Today we're visiting with Dr. Bendell from the Sarah Cannon Research Institute in Nashville, Tennessee. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
Most colon cancer patients are diagnosed with early stage cancer, although some actually do present with advanced disease. And some patients are going to recur from their original diagnosis of colon cancer, and together we call those patients metastatic. Can you explain to our viewers what it means to have metastatic colon cancer?
What it means to have metastatic colon cancer is that the colon cancer has spread outside of the area of the colon. It can spread to usually the liver first, sometimes it spreads to the lungs, and sometimes it spreads to local lymph nodes. Very, very, very rarely, we can sometimes see it spread to bone or brain, but those are very rare cases. But what it tells us is that it's just gone outside of the area of the colon.
So when you see a new patient referred to you with metastatic colon cancer, what do you tell them?
I tell them, first of all, don't lose hope. What I try to do initially is get a sense of where their metastatic disease is, because there's some patients with metastatic disease that we can still cure of their metastatic colon cancer. And it depends if the disease is in the liver only, and it's not all over the liver, but maybe in specific places within the liver, or if it's within the liver and maybe one spot in the lung. Sometimes these patients can be cured with surgical resection of their metastatic disease. And sometimes we'll give chemotherapy before sending them to surgery. Sometimes we'll give it after sending them to surgery. So that's the first thing that I want to check on all of my patients, is to see, are they patients that could possibly be cured of their metastatic disease? If they are, usually I will consult with a surgeon who will help me make that decision as to whether or not a surgical cure is possible for those patients. For patients who are not surgical cure candidates in the metastatic setting, I tell them that our goal is to help them live as well as they can for as long as they can. And what we want to do is combine increasing their survival with chemotherapy treatments with giving them chemotherapy they can tolerate and that they can live every day with and that they don't feel poorly from. So a lot of patients will come in very scared that they're going to get some sort of horrific treatment that's going to make them feel bad. And what I try to do is reassure them that no matter what, we're going to help them with the symptoms. And we're going to help them with the symptoms of their disease as well as the symptoms of their treatment and make it so that they have a good quality of life.
I know that over the past several years, the FDA has approved a lot more drugs for the treatment of colon cancer.
Yeah.
Do doctors approach metastatic colon cancer that they're treating with chemotherapy the same way as their standard approach, or is it quite varied around the country?
It's a little bit varied around the country, and I think with the advent of all of these new agents, you're seeing not just a standard approach to treating the metastatic patient, because you have several types of metastatic patients that are there now, that appear now. One is a type of patient who we could take to a surgical cure right away. The other is a metastatic patient that we might be able to take to a surgical cure if we give them some sort of chemotherapy beforehand. And then there's the type of patient who we won't get to a possible cure, but we can give them a longevity and a quality of life. And so the average oncologist now has to think about all of these three different patients and how you're going to treat and approach these three different patients, which is a very different approach to all of them. A lot of physicians will start with the same type of chemotherapy. The most common chemotherapy regimen used in the United States, probably in metastatic colon cancer, is a combination of FOLFOX plus a drug called bevacizumab, which is the targeted agent that targets the blood vessels. And probably about 60 to 70% of oncologists will use this as their primary regimen for patients with colon cancer. There are other agents that are out there that could be used in the first line setting or as the initial chemotherapy, agents like irinotecan, which are very often used in combination with 5-FU and bevacizumab, or FOLFIRI and bevacizumab. So that is another option that you might see your oncologist talk about. Another is clinical trials. There are so many great clinical trials that are out there right now with some very promising new agents for colon cancer that, if are available, would be wonderful treatment options for patients.
So what role do the EGFR receptors play in the management of metastatic colon cancer?
So EGFR receptor antagonists or antibodies are a new type of targeted agent that go after what I call are almost like TV antennae that are on the outside of colon cancer cells. And what these drugs do is they attach to those TV antennae and tell the cell to stop growing or tell the cell to die. And we've seen that the use of EGFR receptor inhibitors have actually prolonged survival for patients with colon cancer. And their role is becoming even more important now because we're starting to see that there's a specific test that we can use of a patient's tumor to see whether or not they're going to benefit from EGFR inhibitors. And that test is called a Karass mutation analysis. And patients don't have to have new biopsies to get this test done. It can be done on their original surgical colon tumor that was taken out however long ago when they had their original diagnosis of colon cancer. And pathologists can run this test, and if you are somebody who has what we call wild-type Karass, you are very likely to benefit from EGFR inhibitors. And if you're somebody who has a mutation in their Karass, the use of EGFR inhibitors in those particular patients is not worth it. It's shown that the patients who have this mutation get no benefit from EGFR inhibitors. So if you do have the wild-type Karass, EGFR inhibitors can be a benefit to you. And some people are suggesting now that we could even use EGFR inhibitors earlier in therapy, like in initial therapy for patients with colon cancer. And trials to that extent are still being done and studied to know what to optimally do. And as of yet, the FDA has not approved their use as such. But you might see some oncologists that discuss that with their patients or some trials that are looking at that for patients.
So you can assess and tailor therapy in this particular case.
Yes, this is what's very exciting about colon cancer now, is that we're able to start to tailor therapy to the patient specifically. And hopefully within the next few years, we're going to see even more markers start to come up that are going to help us tailor therapy even better. Even with EGFR receptor inhibitors, we've seen other tests such as amphiregulin and epiregulin, P10 mutations, PI3 kinase mutations, that are all start, and BRAF mutations, which are all starting to give us some suggestion as to who might, may or may not respond to EGFR inhibitors and who might be the optimal patient to receive an EGFR inhibitor. And we're going to start to see more of those tests coming for other targeted agents, including bevacizumab, and other targeted agents that are coming in clinical trial down the road.
I've noticed that you've mentioned EGFR receptor inhibitors. Is there more than one?
Yes, there are two EGFR receptor inhibitors that are approved for the treatment of metastatic colon cancer. The first is a drug called cetuximab, and the second is a drug called panitumumab. And they're very, very similar, except their side effect profile is a little bit different. Patients who receive cetuximab have a little bit more of a chance of having an allergic reaction to the cetuximab than patients who receive panitumumab.
It sounds like the treatment options for metastatic disease have really expanded a lot in recent years, and there's certainly much more reason to be hopeful.
Oh, yes. There's so much reason for hope. We've had about 6 drugs approved in the last less than 10 years for the treatment of metastatic colon cancer, and I can only imagine with the trials that we've seen and some of the newer agents that are coming out that we're going to have a whole lot more in the future. So I think there's a whole reason for patients to have hope, and that we're going to cure even more patients and perhaps find that magic combination that will make this disease history.
Now, in other diseases, we're starting to see targeted therapies emerge as a legitimate treatment option.
Yeah.
Is there any work being done with targeted therapies in colon cancer?
Oh, yes. In fact, I think targeted therapies in some senses, and this might be just because I treat a lot of patients with colon cancer, have shown most of their impact in treating patients with colon cancer. For instance, there's an agent called bevacizumab, which is what we call a targeted agent that targets the blood vessels that feed the tumors. And this was the first agent that was shown in colon cancer to prolong patient's survival for what we call the metastatic setting or the stage 4 setting, where the colon cancer is spread outside of the colon itself. We are looking at that in a clinical trial right now in the early stage setting, and we're going to hopefully see some results from that clinical trial in the next couple of months to tell us whether or not that using that targeted agent in the early stage setting is going to benefit patients just as much as it does in the metastatic setting. And there are many more targeted agents that are coming in to be studied with colon cancer. We also have another set of targeted agents called epidermal growth factor receptor inhibitors, EGFR inhibitors, which have been shown in the metastatic setting to prolong patient survival for patients with colon cancer.
Yeah, in summing up, is there anything in particular you'd like to tell cancer patients with metastatic colon cancer that they should really think about when they're diagnosed?
Don't give up hope. Never suffer in silence. Always tell your doctor something's going on, because there's oftentimes something people can do about it. And try clinical trials, because there's so many good trials that are out there that are going to be the way that we find the cure to treating metastatic colon cancer.
Well, it sounds like very good advice, and I really want to thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
And I do hope you'll come back and visit with us again sometime.
Thank you so much.